Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of Business Motion 473 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, setting out a business programme. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer, and formally moved.
Thank you. The question is that Motion 473 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau Motion 474 on a temporary amendment to standing orders. I ask George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, to speak to and move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, this motion amends the Temporary Standing Order Rule 3 to extend the period for which access to the Public Gallery is suspended until the 9th of October 2021. The motion is brought forward to reflect the SPCB's decision on the matter, and members will wish to note that should public health circumstances allow it, it would be possible to reinstate access to the gallery before this date.
Thank you. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of motions 476, 477 and 478 on approval of SSIs, and I ask George Adam, on behalf of the Scottish Government, to speak to and move these motions.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I rise, hopefully for the last time, to move three SSIs. The first being the Health Protection Coronavirus Restriction Requirements Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 25 Regulations 2021. These regulations amend the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions and Requirements Local Level Scotland Regulations 2020 and are amended to allow the temporary removal of face coverings by a person receiving treatments around the mouth and nose. The individual providing the treatment must take appropriate mitigation measures to minimise exposure to coronavirus. Guidance will recommend the type 2 or fluid-resistant surgical mask, plus face shield goggles should be in place for the individual providing the treatment as a mitigating measure. To permit indoor organised activity in Level 2 areas, this adjustment allows non-sporting organised activities to take place in Level 2 areas for individuals of all ages. The changes recognise the social and wellbeing benefit that can be felt for attending such clubs and groups. These regulations came into force on the 31st of May. Moving on, Presiding Officer, we've got the Health and Protection Coronavirus Restrictions Requirement Local Level Scotland Amendment No. 26, Regulations 2021. These regulations amend the Health Protection Coronavirus Restrictions Requirement Local Level Scotland Regulations 2020 and are amended to adjust the allocation of levels throughout Scotland. Moving to Level 2, the City of Glasgow. Moving to Level 1, Highland, Argyll and Bute, Aberdeen City, Aberdeenshire, Moray, Angus, Perth and Kinross, Fife, Falkirk, West Lothian, East Lothian, Inverclyde, Western Bartonshire, Dumfries and Galloway and Borders. Moving to Level 0, the islands in the Highland area except Isle of Skye, Orkney Islands, Shetland Islands, Nyalinthanshire, and I actually asked Dr Allen how to pronounce that, disastrously, the Isle of Colonsay, the Isle of Iona, the Isle of Islay, the Isle of Jura, the Isle of Mull, the Isle of Oronsay, the Isle of Tiree and the Isle of Ulva. To permit no physical distancing when a person being married or entering a civil partnership is being accompanied from one part of a premise to part of those premises where a marriage or civil partnership registration is taking place. This ensures that a party to the marriage or civil partnership can be accompanied down the aisle or similar by a family member or a friend from another household, as is in line with many traditions. To adjust existing exemptions to face covering requirements applying in respect of parties to be married or enter into a civil partnership, to effect that the exemption also applies while they are being accompanied by other persons down the aisle or similar. To permit funfairs to be open in public in Level 2 areas, and these regulations came into force on June the 5th. The final one, Presiding Officer, is the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Scotland Amendment No. 12, Regulations 2021. This instrument makes further amendments to the Health Protection Coronavirus International Travel Regulation 2020 and are amended to remove Portugal from the list of exempt countries, territories, parts of countries or territories in Part 1 or Schedule A1 on principal regulations. The regulations also add Afghanistan, Bahrain, Costa Rica, Egypt, Sri Lanka, Sudan and Trinidad and Tobago to the list of acute acute risk countries, territories and parts of countries or territories in Schedule A2 of the principal regulations. These regulations came into force on the 8th of June.
Thank you. Thank you, Minister. The question on these motions will be put at decision time. There are two questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first is that motion 474, in the name of George Adam, on temporary amendment to standing orders be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. I propose to put a single question on the three SSI motions. Does any member object? The final question is that motions 476, 477 and 478 on approval of SSIs be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. And that concludes decision time and we'll now move on to members' business. And I would ask members who are leaving the chamber to do so quietly.